Hello everyone. Today I wanted to share with you a new maze generating algorithm I came up with. I looked everywhere online and I couldn't find anything like this. But if any of you know of an algorithm that is similar, then please let me know in the comments. A while back, I was looking for an algorithm to use for my upcoming Redstone Maze Generator version 2. I wanted to make this new version a lot smaller than the first, and I just didn't see how I could do that if I stuck with the same algorithm. So I did a bunch of research to find an algorithm with much simpler logic, but I couldn't find anything that was quite what I was looking for. The closest thing I could find was the Aldous-Broder algorithm, but while the logic for this algorithm was incredibly simple, it also had a random runtime, which wasn't ideal. So I tried coming up with my own algorithm, one that would be specifically suited for implementing using Redstone. My goal for this algorithm was for it to have as simple logic as possible, while also having a decent enough runtime. I also wanted this algorithm to result in a perfect maze, that being a maze with no loops or isolated areas. And after a lot of head scratching, this is the algorithm I came up with. We start with a grid of nodes. Each node has a direction property that can either point up, down, left, right, or nowhere. Next, we initialize the grid to be any perfect maze. Now, this may sound a bit silly since the entire purpose of the algorithm is to create a perfect maze, but hear me out. We can use this as our starting point. Every node points to the right, the rightmost nodes point down, and the bottom right node points nowhere. We will call this node the origin node. This is a perfect maze. It doesn't look very fun to solve, but technically it meets all the requirements of a perfect maze, so it will work as the starting point for our algorithm. Keep in mind that these nodes and connections don't represent the walls of the maze, but they instead represent the path that the player can travel along. Next, we repeat the following steps. Have the origin node point to a random neighboring node. That neighboring node becomes the new origin node. Finally, we remove the origin node's pointer. That's it. That's the entire algorithm. Now let's see it in action. So when do we stop? Well, that's the cool thing about this algorithm. You can stop at any time you want, and the resulting maze will always be a perfect maze. If you want a maze that is similar to the original with some differences, you can run it only for a bit, or if you want an entirely new maze, you can run it for longer. But generally, I find that if you run the algorithm for the maze width times the maze height times 10 iterations, it will result in a pretty unique maze, with occasionally a few remnants of the previous maze. So how is it that performing these three steps on any perfect maze will always result in another perfect maze? To understand this, let's first define a set of rules that a maze must follow in order to be considered a perfect maze. 1. Every node except for the origin node must point to one neighboring node. 2. Every node must be connected to the origin node. Let's delve into the first of the two conditions. Here is a simple example. What is the minimum number of connections required to connect three nodes? The answer is 2. How about 4 nodes? The answer is 3. It doesn't matter where the nodes are located or how we connect them, we will always need one less connection than the number of nodes. Let's scale this up to our maze. Here there are 25 nodes. And 24 connections. This explains why we can describe mazes by having each node point to exactly one other node, with a single node pointing nowhere. We're essentially pairing up each connection with a node, and leaving a single node behind. But this rule by itself doesn't assure that the maze will be perfect. Take a look at this maze, for example. This maze satisfies the condition, but it contains one loop and one isolated area. This is why we introduced the second condition. Every node must be connected to the origin node. In other words, if you start from any node and travel along the arrows, you should eventually reach the origin. This assures that there will be no isolated areas, and because a loop requires nodes to point to each other in a cycle, this rule also ensures that there will be no loops. This is why the algorithm works. When we move the origin node, we remove its pointer, and we have what was previously the origin, point to the new origin. after the iteration, the origin node is still the only node that doesn't point anywhere, satisfying the first condition. And by always pointing to the new origin, we assure that the origin node will always be connected to the rest of the maze, satisfying the second condition. So, when should you use this algorithm? Well, outside of the one case I specifically designed it for, that being Minecraft, this algorithm isn't the most practical out there, but there is one interesting use for it that I don't think any other algorithm has. Since after every iteration the maze will be perfect, you can actually play the maze while it's generating. So if any of you game designers out there want to implement a maze that shifts and changes around you into your game, then you can give this algorithm a try. So that's all I have for you today. In the description, I've left a link to the JavaScript I wrote for the algorithm, so if you want to see how the algorithm looks in code, you can check that out. And feel free to use this algorithm in your builds and stuff. If you would like to learn more about maze generation, check out this web app by fellow YouTuber DQWERTYC. It allows you to test out a bunch of different algorithms, as well as letting you go through the algorithm step by step. It's a very helpful app that I highly recommend checking out. I'll link the app and his channel in the description. Make sure to subscribe so you don't miss the next video where I implement this algorithm in Minecraft using redstone, and let me know what I should name the algorithm down in the comments. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you later.